The native Tesla app is great for a lot of things, but unfortunately, controls is not one of them. I'm Frugal Tesla Guy, and I've got an app that has all of the controls, like unlocking the doors and opening the frunk, in one convenient place. And the best part? It's free. If you own a Tesla, then chances are you have embraced the technological wonder that it is. Autopilot, Sentry Mode, and watching Netflix while you charge are just some of the things it does for us. Even the simple task of unlocking the doors or opening the trunk from your phone are tasks many of us have only experienced for the first time since we got our Tesla. But after using these features for a while, you begin to realize that the native Tesla app could be designed better for easier access. And I'll show you what I'm talking about. Now, upon opening the app, there are three commonly used tasks on the home screen: turning on and off climate control, opening the frunk, and locking or unlocking the doors. But what if you want to open the trunk or open the charge port? You need to open the control screen in order to do that. However, opening the charge port is actually in a different menu. Now you need to go back to the home page and then open the charging window, and from there, you can open the charge port. Now, some may consider this to be a bit nitpicky, but if you're in a hurry or have your hands full, sometimes it's just nice to be able to get it done without having to figure out which menu you need to open the trunk or frunk or perform any other task. It'd be nice if you just opened up the app and the task you needed was right there on the home screen. This is where a new app that was developed by Amptech comes in. Now, Amptech is a company based in Germany that focuses on making the already great experience with your Tesla even better. You may recognize them for their flagship products such as the auto opening and closing frunk and trunk, and now they have entered the app arena. Now, they decided to take some of the more popular features from the native Tesla app and put them all in one place. So when you open the app, it looks like this. Almost every feature that can be controlled from the app is right here. And simply put, the all work is advertised. So let's see the app in action. Now, upon opening the app, you'll notice the avatar right there at the center of your screen. And the cool thing is, right from this home page, there are a lot of things that you can see as far as the status of your car is concerned, which you'll see as we go through in this video. So we start with the green padlock above the avatar. And what this tells you is that the car is locked. And if you want to unlock it, you simply press that green padlock, and it will ask you to confirm by pressing yes, and it will unlock your car. Once the car is unlocked, it will turn red. And when you want to lock the door again, you press the red padlock, and you don't need to confirm, it will just automatically lock the door for you and turn green to let you know the car doors are locked. Now, in the upper right-hand portion of the screen is Sentry Mode. And again, upon opening the app, you'll be able to see whether or not Sentry Mode is on. When the center circle is white, what that tells you is that Sentry Mode is off. And if you want to turn it on, you simply press the icon and the dot will turn from white to red to let you know that it's on. To the right of that is Summon. Now, as of right now, it's not available on this app, but it will be soon. So if you do indeed have Summon, you'll be able to access that feature from this app. Below that is the avatar, and you can see other things such as the name of your car. You can also see the percentage of the battery, and below that is some more information such as the interior temperature of the car, whether or not the car is in park, drive, or reverse, and the estimated range in your battery. And below that is the location of your car, which is in writing here, but if you want to see it on a map, you just press that gray bar and the location of your car will show up on the map. Now, you can see it on a regular map or with satellite view. When you want to go back to the home page, simply press the arrow in the upper left and it will take you there. The very bottom portion of the screen is where you have a lot of controls for the car, and this is what a lot of people have been waiting for. And that is an easy location for most of the controls for your car. So, for example, you can see the frunk. Now, when you want to open the frunk, you tap that icon and will ask you to confirm by pressing yes. Once you do that, it'll show you two different ways that the frunk is open. Number one, the icon turns red with the frunk that is open, and the avatar at the center of the screen also shows that the frunk is open. Same thing when you want to close the frunk. It will ask you to confirm, and it will close the frunk for you. Now, in order for this to work the way you see it here, you have to have an automatic opening and closing frunk. Now, to the right of that is the charge port button. Now, open the charge port, you press that icon, and it will show you a padlock in red to show you that it's open. And if the car is charging, it will show you with an animating lightning bolt with green flashing through it and a green padlock. To the right of that is the biohazard button, which we'll go over a little bit later. To the right of that is a door that says the word closed underneath it. What that tells you is that the windows are closed. If you'd like to open the windows partially, tap that icon and the door will turn red and it will say ventilation underneath it. What that tells you is that the windows are partially open. Now, if you want to close the windows, tap that same icon and that red door will turn black again and say closed. To the right of that is the trunk button. It'll ask you to confirm and you will tap yes and it will open the trunk for you. And it will show you in the two different ways, much like that of the frunk, with a red icon with an open trunk or the avatar that shows the trunk open. And if you want to close the trunk, you tap the red trunk icon and it will close the trunk for you. Now we go to the bottom row and we start on the bottom left, which is the driver's side seat heater. And it works as you'd expect. It's got the three different levels, and to turn it off, you just give it a quick tap. To the right of that is the climate control. Now, as you can see here, that fan is not spinning and it says off. If you'd like to turn on the climate control, tap that fan icon and it will take you to climate control settings. You can adjust the temperature of the interior of the car by tapping the plus or minus button, and it will turn on the AC or the heat depending on what you need. You'll also notice that when you go back to the home page, it will show an animating fan to let you know that the climate control is on. And when you want to turn off the climate control, you tap that spinning fan. It will take you back to climate control settings, and you simply push that blue button and it will turn it off for you. Then when you go to the home page, the fan will no longer be spinning. To the right of that is the battery, and quite honestly, it's pretty much set up the same way as the native Tesla app. It functions the same way. You can control how much you'd like to charge the battery, and it'll show you the nearest supercharging stations and destination chargers. To the right of that is the start button, and of course, that will start the car for you, and you will need to confirm by tapping yes. And to the right of that is the passenger side seat heater. Now, another thing to take note, if you happen to have seat heaters for all five seats, you can access those seat heaters in the climate control section and turn those on and off as you need. Now, I want to go back to that biohazard button I was talking about earlier. This is a really cool feature because not only does it lock the doors, but let's say you have the frunk open and the windows open, the charge port might be open, and even your trunk. By pressing the biohazard button, not only will it lock the doors, but it will close the frunk, it will close the charge port, it will close all of your windows, and if you have the automatic opening and closing trunk, it will close that as well. Now, based on that demonstration, you could say that the biohazard button is a great way to secure your car, but it also has a hidden feature. If you press the biohazard button and hold it down, the screen will turn red and count up from 1 to 3. Once it reaches 3, the car horn will start honking, and it will continue to honk as long as you hold the biohazard button down. Once you let go, the car horn will stop. This is a great feature because you could use it as security or if you want to find your car in a large parking lot. Now, one of the other cool things about this app is the fact that the avatar at the center of your screen gives you the status of a few features of your car, such as the frunk and trunk as to whether or not they're open or not, but it'll also show you if the doors are open or not as well. So if the doors are open, it'll show them open and vice versa. And another cool thing is if you're not driving and you want to check the status of the car, you can see if it's in park or reverse. And if the car is driving, the wheels will actually be spinning and you'll be able to see the speed of the car as well. In the upper left-hand corner of the screen are three lines. If you tap that, that will bring down more menu items. At the top, it gives the name of the car and the mileage of your car as well. And everything below that has either free features or paid features. And this is actually, for the sake of time, a section of the app that I think deserves its own video, as we'll go over all of these menu items and on top of that, which ones are free and which ones aren't. But in the meantime, when you do download the app, all of the features will be free, including the paid features, for a 30-day period. That way you won't be committed, and if you discover you don't need those paid features, you can opt out. Now here's the cool part. Everything that was just demonstrated is completely free with no gimmicks. They also have plans to add the Apple Watch to the mix. Now, you might also be asking about security. Well, first and foremost, if this is a concern of yours, then you are most likely using multi-factor authentication with your Tesla account. In fact, the AmpTech app won't allow you to log in unless you're using multi-factor authentication. Now, if you want to learn more about that, I have a video explaining how to set that all up. Now, if you haven't done so already, you may want to consider it, whether or not you want this app. Now, that all being said, your Tesla credentials are not able to be accessed by AmpTech when you enter them. It's sent to Tesla, and then they grant the app access. So your credentials aren't stored anywhere with AmpTech. Now, if you'd like to download the app, go to your phone's App Store, iOS or Android, and search for AmpTech. The original plan with this video was to upload it on the day it was released for both Android and Apple. Now, as I'm recording this part of the video, it has been available for Android for about a week. Unfortunately, it has been rejected several times by Apple. And really, quite honestly, there is no rhyme or reason to this. Because if you look at what AmpTech is offering in their app and compare it to what other apps are offering, there isn't any functionality differences, control differences. And this is where many of us, and including AmpTech, are scratching their heads as to why it's been rejected so many times. Now, they are working diligently to try to resolve this issue. But in the meantime, if you do have an Android device, you will be able to download it without any issues. However, you're going to have to hang tight if you're an iOS user. Now, when it does indeed become available in the App Store, I will post that in the description below of this video. And if you happen to follow me on Instagram or Twitter, I'll of course be sure to post that in those forms of social media. So here are my overall thoughts on the app. If you're not into all of that geeky information, such as the diagnostics, the analytics, a lot of the statistics for your car, and you just want a place that's easy to navigate, that has most of the controls for your car, then I say look no further than the AmpTech app. Sure, there are a lot of other apps out there that offer the same functionality, but they come at a cost. And they may offer more things because of that, but others, not so much. But some of these apps I do support. But AmpTech has a lot of resources, and they're able to offer this up to you for free. Now, as I mentioned, they do offer some of that geeky stuff I was talking about, and they will have to charge you a fee to help cover the costs of the storage, but we'll go over those fees and that functionality in a different video. But the thing is, with this app, this has what a lot of people are looking for. And I love the fact that you don't have to pay a cent for it. So I'd love to know what you think in the comment section below. Is this an app you've been looking for? Are you looking for an app that's free? Are you leery of giving your credentials to a different app, which is fully understandable, but we went over the reasons why that shouldn't be a concern. I'd love to hear what you think about all of this in the comment section below. Well, thank you all so much for watching, and you know the drill. Like, subscribe, and stay positively charged.